Rodney Crowell, Delbert McClinton, Leroy Parnell, Mike Ferris, Liz Brazier, Steve Poltz, Sarah Potenza, Mandy Barnett, Jason Ringenberg, the McCreary Sisters, Lily May, Reverend Sekou, Robbie Fulks, Peterson Brothers, Pat Byrne, the Warren Treaty, Molly Tuttle, and the Cordovas. A limited number of day passes are being released. Friday evening, $50, and all day Saturday, $75. Or get a weekend pass to benefit WMOT at 895fest.org.
Got original 1938 Chevrolet. I think it's a Special Deluxe, or it might be a Master Deluxe. Or a Master Special. Anyhow, this is original back from 1938. This is the head for it. It usually comes with a big old box and tables off of it. But what we've done, we've custom built it for a guy. And it turned out pretty nice. That you wear your normal background light in it. We have that fixed so you wire it to the dash lights. So it'll come on with the dash lights. Ain't no need of it burning there all the time. Make it hard to change. And we've custom built a case for it. We've done a full Aurora Design conversion in it. It now has a AM FM stereo, auxiliary in, which is automatic. It's got four channels out, 45 watts of channel built in it. It's got a pre-out on it if you want to add a sub to it. So this thing will rock pretty good. It's got a USB port. This is your harness you'll be getting. You can hide it in the car, put it wherever you want to. This here will play a thumb drive, which comes with it, with this video on it and music. Also, we'll charge your phone, your devices. Right here is your auxiliary in. You put that in there, you can plug any kind of head into it, your phone, satellite radio, CD changers, anything you want to into here. Comes with a male-to-male cord. You just keep that in your glove box, take it out, and plug something into it. When you turn it on, by what I mean automatically, when you turn it on, hit play, the radio will automatically change over to it. The USB is push-button operated and control operated. So is your Bluetooth. It has Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, streaming your music, voice command, voice ID. This radio will also scan your stations for you. And it's pretty cool. It's fully loaded. This is your mic. Plenty of extension because there's no really place to drill a hole to put it in this radio. So here's your mic. You can run it up to where you can get close to it and plug it in the back. Right now you're on FM. And I've got where I really don't put a lot of LEDs in these small ones because it's such a pain and you wind up with light problems. So you don't really need it. She talks to you all the time.
Eve in oil paint.
See the great.
In it. Not around.
You're at the desert.
Well,
pretty well covers all your stations and FM.
Say, oh, we got it. He committed.
We'll go to AM radio. You got a switch over here. We actually used it. So you got AM FM switching. There's AM radio.
You're right.
Back to FM. Back to AM. You had a toner switch in it, treble and bass. If you hook up two speakers, you'll have a balance built in your toner control, and we'll demonstrate that. If you hook up three or more, you have a balance and fader. Because you run four speakers, you need to fade them and balance them. So I'll show you how that works. First thing we're going to do, I'm going to show you how to put it in the scanning mode and let it start scanning stations. And I'm going to show you how to lock on one when you find it. So if you're going down the road, you can let the radio find you a station to listen to. Take your tuning knob and turn it up twice.
Scanning for stations.
Now it's going to start scanning.
U.S. Postal Service. And by the time we buy the mailer and we mail it to you, that's just a little bit over $3.
Of the eternal sun comes
transcends in time and space in order to reveal God.
Now I'm going to show you how to lock on a station and even find it if you want to. So you like that station? Well, we better not do that, and we'll get in trouble for that one. Just let it go one more. Say you like it stationary, you take the tuning knob and turn it one time, she'll lock on it.
Station hold.
Alright, as soon as she says that, if you want to move it, you can find where that is at. If you want to just kind of remember, there it is. Now you're on FM, you got AM dial, you'd like to know where you're at, just call Voice ID, it'll do it on AM and FM, it'll scan on AM and FM. It'll also tell you where you're at. Take the volume knob and turn it up three times. One, two, three.
FM 93.7.
That's pretty cool. So it'll tell you that. That's pretty neat. All built in this little radio. Alright, we're going to do an auxiliary in. You just pull out your male-to-male cable and plug it in. Make sure I'm plugged in all the way back here. Bring your device up, plug it in, all you gotta do is turn it on. Don't matter what device it is, just hit play. Automatically changes over. It just don't seem
fair. See if you can spot this one.
Now anytime you're on auxiliary in and you want to go back to radio, just take your device, no matter what it is, and just turn it off. In 20 seconds, the radio will go back if you do not touch it to where we had it set. If you want to narrow that 20 seconds down, just turn the radio off and right back on. But if you don't turn it off and back on, it will automatically change over for you. That's how your auxiliary works in. All right, let's go back down here and find some music. Now I'm going to show you how to work the balance and fader. We got four speakers hooked up on it. This is your toner. You're on wide open treble right now. Just back it up just a little bit. And to go into fader, you're going to go twice on this clockwise. She's going to come on and say fader adjust. And as long as you're moving this, after she says fader adjust, you can adjust your speaker from front to rear. When you find what you want, just stop, she'll set it.
Fader adjust.
There's the rears, fronts. I'm gonna balance it out, let her set it.
Fader set.
There we go. Now we're gonna go to balance, which is counterclockwise. One, two.
Balance adjust.
Right side, left side. As long as you're moving it, it'll stay there until you want to balance it out. Let's balance it out. She'll set it.
Balance set.
Now you're back on treble and bass. Now you don't have to do both at the same time. You can do just fader and you'll go back to your toner. You can do just balance, go back to your toner. All right, now we're going to run our Bluetooth in. We're going to do the initial pair up. You will do the same thing, and it will take multiple devices. It'll always pick number one. And don't forget, this push button now works with these knobs. So what I do here, we can do here. I'm going to take the push button and hold it down and let her help us pair it up.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Showed up on her phone. All we gotta do is tap on it. She'll tell us when it's done.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Alright. Now we're connected up. We're gonna do a voice command. We're gonna check the mic out, make sure it works. Now I can hold this button down again and bring my phone up and tell it what to do. Call home, look up a restaurant, play music, whatever you want to, by holding this button down, bringing the phone up. We're also going to do it with the volume knob. Let's do it with the volume knob this time. All we do is twice. One, two. Play music. That's going to music on my phone. My phone's a little slow because I see a big old crack. I dropped it. Let's see, she said.
Playing all songs. Shuffled.
There we go. All right, we're going to go to my music so we can see what we're doing. If you want to advance your songs, you got two ways of doing it. Push a button, we'll advance. Twice, we'll back up or repeat. Depends on how long you're into the song. We can also do it with the tuning knob. Go up, that'll change it. Up, up. Up,
country
back,
boy.
Phone call comes in, she'll come on and say, incoming call. When she says that, you'll hear it ring. You can press this button one time to answer your call or take your tuning knob and turn it up one click. Like I was doing changing the song. To end the call, you can let the phone hang up and it will go back to doing whatever you're doing by itself. You can end the call by pressing this twice or turning the tuning knob back down. And whatever the radio is doing, it'll go back to doing what it was doing. So, click, click, click. And that's how you change your music on your Bluetooth, on your phone. All right. My phone's not wanting to do right. All right. So now let's tell it to go back to radio. We're going to stop music. We're going to do it this way or this way. We're going to do it this way this time. We're going to hold the button down. Bring our phone up. Stop music. Put it in pause. Go right back to radio. Now, once you do the initial pair up, we're going to do another test. We're going to turn the radio off. We've done the initial pair up. So it will take multiple devices. It will always pick number one. So if you're a primary driver or you're the one that wants to answer all the phone calls, that's the one you want to do first. But it will take multiple devices. And what we're going to do is turn it on and make sure she finds the phone now since we paired it up.
Bluetooth connected.
There we are. Now we're connected up. So now we're going to do the USB. You're going to get one of these with this video on it and some music. And you can hide this. A lot of people, you can hide it where people can't see it because you don't have to take this in and out all the time. When you first put it in, it's going to go straight to it. Now you can change your music the same way. Push that button, advance. Twice to back up or repeat. Turn it up here, back. To go to pause, because you say you got this head, you don't want to take a stick out, you want to go back to radio. All you do is you take this push button and hold it down 1 second. Put this in pause, it'll cycle right back around the radio. Of course, you've been fooling with this, so we don't know if we're on the station or not. Yeah, we are. Alright. Same way, going down the road, if you're going to go to USB, you're driving down the road, you don't have to stick that in there, it's already in there. 1 second. Right back to it. Change our music right here. Up, back. Now, your button works with these here, so we went up on the volume knob, and all this is in your manual that I'm telling you. I make the videos just so some people can understand. We went up. Up on the volume knob to summon our phone up. Let's go down to do the same thing push button does to this. Put it in pause. Put it in pause, right back to radio. Radio's got a ton of features on it. Back on radio. We won't go thumb drives. We don't have to use a push button. Go down twice, right back to thumb drive. Overall length from here to the back is a little under 6 inches. And this is just a hair wider than the face, so you should be able to get it in there. I've got a hanger here so you can put a back support on it. Just don't put it in a bind. It's all bolted together and soldered, and it should last a long time. You got a heat sink from here to here. Everything plugs in the back of it. You got your even your antennas on extendable, so it'll hang down and you can get to that. Make sure you have a good antenna. Check your antenna. You can ohm it out and make sure you're getting continuity so you got a good antenna. All right, let's go back to radio. Put it in pause, go right back to radio. Back on radio.
Entertainment.
We got
a butter man again.
And Ashley Home Store celebrating the.
Put you in some good speakers, she's going to rock for you. This is your original 1938 Chevrolet Deluxe Master, I believe. I ain't got the paperwork down here. It's in the office. I think it's a special, Deluxe Special or Master Special. But anyhow, Deluxe Special is what it is. Original AM radio. I'm sure they've got the bizzle now. And all you got to do is put it in there and wire it up. You'll get full instructions, full manual. Thumb drive, a video on it, the whole nine yards. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Thank you.